I want to draw policy contrast between the NDC and NPP. Mr. Speaker, the impression is created that, oh, both parties are the same, and economic management is the same. Mr. Speaker, it's not the same. As a matter of fact, the NPP are better managers of the economy. Yeah. Mr. Speaker, in 11 months, what the economic management team headed by the Vice President, the Minister of Finance, what they have done, Mr. Speaker, no wonder the President says the Minister is a magician. Mr. Speaker, in April 2015, we entered into a three-year, $980 million extended credit facility program with the IMF. Going to the IMF in and of itself does not guarantee success. There are program targets. In the IMF program, we were to restore debt sustainability. We were also to restore macroeconomic stability, to return to high growth, to strengthen monetary policy, build external buffers. Mr. Speaker, under the NDC's watch, in the IMF program, debt sustainability, you did 73% debt to GDP ratio. Under this government, we've come down to 68.8%. Yeah. Yeah. Mr. Speaker, when you talk of restoring macro stability, you ended the year inflation 15.4%. Today, as I speak, we are at 11.6%. Yeah. Mr. Speaker, the economic growth that they recorded in 2016, 3.7, it was the lowest in 23 years. The lowest economic growth in 23 years. Now, guess what the better managers of the economy have done? We've sent it to a projected 7.9 this year. Yeah. Mr. Speaker, we've built external buffers. Import cover, as I speak, 3.9 months import cover, whereas they left it at 2.5. So, what did we gain under the NDC from joining the IMF? What did we gain? All the set out targets, Mr. Speaker, we missed. As a matter of fact, Mr. Speaker, presently, all the international credit rating agencies have given Ghana an improved outlook of our credit rating. It just doesn't happen. You need better managers of the economy to make it happen. It just doesn't happen. Mr. Speaker, under their watch, every year, they were going to the international capital market, Eurobond market. It was a regular fixture. 2013, they were there. 2014, they were there. 2015, 2016, they were borrowing from the international capital market. We came and we said, we are not going to do the refinancing that you were doing. That didn't bring any benefits. Mr. Speaker, we reprofiled the debt. In April, we reprofiled 10 billion of the domestic debt. It has to come with some benefits. After reprofiling, interest rates drop. As we speak, 91-day, 13%. You left it around 20%. 182-day, it has also come down, 14%. Mr. Speaker, one-year note is at 15%. It just doesn't happen. You need better managers of the economy to make it happen. Yeah.